Tonight, we're wrapping up our five-part series, Medical Innovations Helping People Live the Healthiest Lives Possible. News 3 Tests' Ray Chin shows us tonight how robots are helping loved ones suffering from atrial fibrillation.
Imagine this, a doctor at one end of the room while the patient in another during surgery. That's what some doctors at Intermountain Medical Center are doing thanks to remote magnetic robots.
How are you doing?
So good.
68-year-old Michael Larkins of Draper needed his heart to get back to normal rhythm for the second time in 6 years.
My doctor informed me, you've got a cousin. You've got a first cousin of fib. It's called flutter.
But this time, robots would do the work.
Where robotics fits in is yet another tool.
It's possible with the Stereotaxis Remote Magnetic Navigation System.
We're coming into a new era when we talk about how we treat our patients in cardiology and electrophysiology.
Dr. Peter Weiss at Intermountain Medical Center Heart Institute is in the control room directing the catheter, which is controlled by a magnetic pole. The patient nearby is hugged by the instrument's large magnets.
The robotic system allows us to move the catheter in a very controlled fashion within the body. Not only that, the catheter itself is floppy as opposed to being stiff. In traditional procedures where we stand next to the patient's hip and move the catheters using our hands from the hip, catheters have to be stiff so we can move them in and out and direct them where they need to go.
Dr. Weiss remotely maps out and moves the catheter inside the patient's heart. Tiny electrical pulses correct the arrhythmia.
Here, the catheter is floppy like a wet noodle and is pulled along by the magnetic field. So when it encounters tissue, instead of a stiff catheter bouncing along, the catheter moves with the tissue.
The breakthrough technology allows precision and helps doctors treat hard-to-reach places in the minimally invasive procedure. The tool eliminates the risk of puncturing the heart, and it improves patient outcomes.
5 days out from the ablation experience, I'm feeling really good.
The technology was just coming online when Michael needed his first fix. He underwent a traditional manual ablation. Several years later, Intermountain Medical Center is closing in on 1,000 procedures, half of them for AFib. Dr. Weiss now uses the innovation for 90% of the time in the operating room.
We look forward to continuing to push the technologies forward to the extent that they show good promise.
Dr. Weiss doesn't worry robotics will one day take his job away. Instead, he says it allows him to be even better.
That these are really tools that we are bringing in to help us take better care of the patient. But the key things are still the decision making, the planning, the communication, the things that really make us physicians.
Safety is the hallmark in all of these medical innovations we've highlighted this week at Intermountain Medical Center.
I think it's very exciting.
For the doctor that's manually manipulating the catheters, very stressful. If the technology enhances his ability to do what he does even just a little bit better, that's in my favor.
To catch up on all five parts of our series, Medical Innovations Helping People Live the Healthiest Lives Possible, go to our website, goodforutah.com. In the newsroom, I'm Sarai Chin.